Okay, so here we go again. It's a familiar place for us. This is outside Mark's, a Cheshire Particle. I've come over again tonight to pick up the bait for our next trip. So this is Carp Bible's latest video edition, and it's a week's fishing in Lake Beauregard in France. I have done a video in 2016 on this lake where we did quite well. I think we had 650s in a week there. At the time, I didn't know Mark at that point, but there was a particle ban on the lake at the time, but I'm sure Mark will say that Roger, the owner, has seen sense since then, and he has lifted the particle ban. So as we usually do on our trips now, we've come and loaded up, and we've got 140 kilo of the multi-mix that we're taking with us this time. And so this is Thursday today. Slightly different with the lads this time. We've got a few old boys that come out with us. They won't be too happy that I've said that about them, but that's the truth of it, and they don't want to travel through the night. So we're setting off tomorrow morning, and we're actually doing 100 mile in France, and then we found a campsite that's got a small lake on it. So we're going to have a north versus south match tomorrow night, 4.5 hour match, and we've got a carp rod on. We're having a match fisherman, so there's going to be three anglers per team, two fishing and one's a bank runner on a 1/2 hour rotation. So that'll be interesting. There's a few secret rules that the lads don't know about that I'll tell them tomorrow, that will be on film, that you'll see some interesting looks on their faces when they find out what the rules are for the match. But so what I'm going to do this time, I'm going to do a separate video for the match tomorrow, and then I'm going to do a week-long video of the trip like I did last time. So so obviously I've wanted Mark to be in this because we've something slightly different that we've decided to do this time, and it's pure generosity from Mark. So do you want to explain what the situation is, mate?
Yeah, we're going to do a competition.
Okay.
Running through the Carp Bible.
Right.
We're going to put up 20 kilo of the multi-mix.
Okay. So this is the prize that we've got on display here, isn't it? Yeah, 20 kilos there.
Yeah. Well, there's obviously 10 there, but there's 10 behind.
Yeah. You can see them there as well. There's 10 there and 10 at the top there.
So we're going to give up 20 kilo of this as a prize, which Dan will go into further on the video. He'll give you the details, what you need to be doing, how to get it, how to win it. And we'll, when it's all come about the end, and the prize winner, we'll ship it out to the competition winner.
Free of charge. So that's massively generous. And that, and obviously I'll advocate for it, the multi-mix. We've got 140 kilo of it coming with us this time. I think we took 160 last time, 140 the time before. So, you know, I just love it as a mix. It's an awesome one. But so that's the deal. So 20 kilo of the particle delivered is going to be the prize. What I'm going to do is, further on in the video, I'll explain what the competition is, and then when I release it through the Carp Bible Facebook page, there'll be some incentive in there, because we've also decided that to throw into the mix, and I'm not entirely sure at the minute, we've only sort of decided that now. I've had some Carp Bible t-shirts printed up for the lads, and I have got one spare, so I'm going to throw that in as part of the prize. And Mark's kindly said that he'll throw one of the Cheshire Particle t-shirts in as well. So there'll be a prize. The definite prize is going to be 20 kilo of the bait delivered, but there'll be some incentives in there to get two free t-shirts thrown into the mix as well. So really, that could ultimately be the prize that you're going to win: 20 kilos of Mark's bait and a t-shirt from the Bible and a t-shirt from Cheshire Particle. So definitely worth tuning into. So
most definitely.
Yeah, just very quickly, mate, then, before we wrap this up, because I know you're off on a trip out, a secret trip out, we won't say too much about that, and I've got to go and pick up Andy to get our gear sorted. So so products wise, I'd seen a few pictures of some particle in buckets, so that's something you started doing now as well,
isn't it? Yeah, we started doing the 5 litre buckets, I mean full to the brim of particle.
Right, okay, yeah.
I mean that could be, there's a choice, there's a multi-mix, there's the Emp and Maize,
right.
There's Party Mix, there's Tiger Nuts.
Yeah.
It's all there on the website, whichever you want to pick, it's intelligent. Okay. Obviously, the Tiger Nuts don't compact down as much as the particle does.
Yeah.
So you roughly, approximately, you're getting 5 kilo of particle in per bucket.
Right.
The Tigers, you're approximately getting around 4.5 kilo because it won't compact down.
Okay, yeah.
But
yeah,
still, you're getting a bucket with it.
Yeah. So it's a 5 litre bucket, including branded bucket, and the particle inside it delivered out.
Yeah.
So for anybody who wants that for simplicity, wants it in a bucket ready to go, then that's another.
Everybody loves a bait bucket, don't
they? Yeah, of course they do. Well, you certainly like them. You've got plenty of them over there anyway, mate. So so that's where we're up to. So just keep an eye on the Carp Bible Facebook page. Keep an eye on Mark's Cheshire Particle, because I think from last time that we met and did this, You've had a couple of lads come on board that are doing a bit more around the social media stuff, aren't you? So, so any new products that Mark releases will go on there. And it's, you know, I'll always do it. You can't advocate enough for the stuff. It's the masses of choice within the range. Mark's always been open to custom mixes as well. You give him a shout, drop him a recipe, ask him if he can do it, he'll get it sorted out, delivered out to you. All comes in 2.5 kilo bags, so you're not getting 10 kilos altogether that you've got to open and spoil, and then obviously you could have it in a bucket now if you want as well. So hopefully by the time you finish watching this video, there's going to be a load of fish caught on this particle, which I'm confident that the lads are good enough. If I have to carry them again, I will do, but that will be nothing new. They won't like me saying that. So So look forward to watching the rest of the video, and Mark will look forward to getting his product posted out to you.
Yeah.
And also, what will be great, whoever wins the competition, if you use it and catch a few fish on it, get them posted on Mark's page, get them posted on Carp Bible page, and that'll be cool. And I'm sure that'll incentivise further competitions in the future. So cool. Right, cheers, mate.
Cheers, Dan.
Good to catch up
nice
again.
Nice to see you again.
And
yeah.
You.
Yeah.
Start again.
Yeah.
Okay, so here we go. This is the first update since we've been in France, and the pond that you can see behind us is the campsite that we've come to tonight. This is Vivier au Carp, the campsite's called. Unfortunately, it's Vivier au No Carp at the minute, because we are in the middle of having a match, which I'll pan round and show you on the camera in a minute, and we haven't had any carp yet. We've caught, I think, probably about
a dozen
six to ten roach between the two teams. Obviously, you can see we're in our team colours. We don't dress like this, I just certainly don't dress like this every day. So these are our lass. Pants. Let's see if I can just show you the full attire.
You really want to get your pants.
There we go. Look at that. Her beauties took ages to make them. And Pete's got his famous. He's
South colours.
Let's have a look at the back of that, mate. See what we've got on the back of it. What was that?
Southern
Shandy drinkers. There we go. That's what we like. A bit of honesty on our film. So, yeah. So this is the match I was talking about before, the Friday night match, but. I thought I may have a few carp to show you on the camera, but as of yet, none. Just a few roach. So if anybody does hook into a carp, I will. I'll get them on film, hopefully, and we'll get ready for the big weigh-in at the end of it. But if we make a pound between us in the two teams, it'll do well. So there is a lot riding on this. There's a big prize at the end of it that nobody knows about. So I'll tune back in at the end.
Right.
When Pete's got tired arms because he caught so many fish, maybe.
Yeah, right. Don't count on it.
Right, so here we are, the winning team of the first match of the week. This was the Holy Grail Friday night match, and unfortunately, Team South have taught us a lesson when it comes to catching tiddlers, which we don't mind. So what was the winning total weight?
520 grams.
520 grams for a 5-hour match, or four hours, whatever it was. Not bad, not a bad effort. Okay, right.
Top so Bible bashers.
So we've got till next Saturday to win this trophy back off of them. But well done, lads. You taught us a lesson tonight, we have to admit.
Yes!
Not as creative on the outfit, but you can catch silverfish, we'll give you that. Okay, happy days. Okay, so here we are. This is just a very quick video tonight. Just as an introduction to this week's Carp Bible French adventure, I guess. So, yeah, I've obviously done a bit so far when we met Mark to get the particle from him. And a few little clips of the match last night that didn't really transpire into a match. It was pretty poor, to be honest with you, the campsite. The lake may well be stocked with bream and tench and carp and crucian and roach, but we found it very difficult. Didn't really see signs of anything other than just small roach, and hence the match weights ended up being 260 grams for Team North and 520 grams for Team South, and made up of just small roach, so it was quite disappointing really. This is only going to be quick, because as you can see I'm getting absolutely hounded by mosquitoes. So we're back at Lake Beauregard again for a week, Saturday evening now. Got here, we stayed overnight in France last night and drove down this morning, got it on the lake at 12 o'clock as directed in the rules. I met Roger, had a quick catch up with him, had a chat about how the guys got on last week, did a walk round and did a draw. Very quickly I came out third in a watercraft draw, so you may recognise that in the background from last time, but I've chose to come back in peg 6 again, so I think this is my 5th trip here and the 4th time that I've fished peg 6. To be fair, we've seen fish all over the lake walking around and during the day today. They've been showing in front of 1, in front of 3, in front of 12, in front of 10, 9, 11, 6. They've been everywhere, to be honest with you. So I'm feeling hopeful for a few fish this week. So I'll do a proper introduction tomorrow. This was just really quick tonight, just in case I get any fish this evening or during the night, and I put them on the video so you know what's going on and it's not just a random start to the video. So peg 6 for me for the week. I may stay here. There is peg 4 available. There's always one free peg for someone to move into. Someone else may move into 4, which again will free up another one for us. So and I tend not to stay in the same place for a full week. I normally move once or twice during the week, but I do like 6. I found a few spots today. I've only just got the rods out. I've not even got my bed in my bivvy. All my stuff's all over the bank, so I need to sort that now. I spent more time today finding spots, really, for the first couple of hours. So I'm happy with where I am. I may change off them in the week, depending on what goes on, but I think I'm just going to stick with them for the first few days, certainly. So obviously, last time we came, the video that I did in 2016, that was April, much cooler. It's been 20-odd degrees today, and it's looking like it's going to be 20-odd degrees every day. April was about 8 to 10 degrees in the day, getting down to minus 3 at night, and we did quite well. I can't remember exactly how many fish we had, 30 or 30-odd, but we did have 650s that week. And Roger mentioned before that they had a few fish between 3 of them on here last week, but none of the big ones come out, so hopefully that means we'll get a few this week and the 6 of us on here this week. So like I said, I'm just going to have to get sorted and get me bivvy done and me mozzie paddles in, because I'm getting absolutely hammered here by mosquitoes. So unless I catch something during the night, I will check back in again in the morning, hopefully with some fish updates from around the lake and the lads. I'll just introduce who I'm fishing with on this trip this week and take it from there. So look forward to doing the video, and I shall see you tomorrow, if not before. Okay, so here we go. This is the first morning on Lake Beauregard, Sunday morning. Did a little bit of an update last night just to let everybody know what peg I was fishing on. A bit of a rush on the first day, as it always is, but from what I can gather, there's one fish come out last night, unfortunately. As you can see, the position of minutes come to me, so got it this morning, and it is 45-pound 2-ounce mirror, so awesome way to start the week. Caught this one on a impulse baits apex. That's the first time we've tried it, so I made up with that. Better Mark's particle out, half a kilo of apex over the top, a few of Roger's pellets that he sells at the lake, Sar pellet, and half a kilo of them, and then job's a good one. Got it this morning, so I'll just lift her up. She's been in the retainer for a bit while I get the camera set up, so she may be a bit lively, but let's see how we get on. Happy days. 45-pound 2-ounce mirror. Here we go, see how this goes. I'm on a bit of a slope as well, so it's not ideal, but I'll try my best. Let's have a look at her. Beautiful fish, absolutely beautiful. Yep, here we go. Come on, girl. Had a feeling this might be fun and games with this one. A bit camera shy, I think. Hang on. Come on, let's get you up. Yeah, we'll get it. There we go. We'll just finally emerge from his bark back. There we go, look at that, absolute beast of a fish. Beautiful. Like I said, 45-pound, 2 ounces, mirror carp, Beauregard mirror carp, caught on a 14mm, 15mm apex over a bed of particle. Beautiful. Okay, so this is just a quick bit of an impromptu recording. I'm just trying to get focused in on it. This is Will on peg 12. He's hooked into a fish just as I've come round to make breakfast. So the zoom on this camera should be able to get relatively close. So it looks like he's just got it in the net. Oh, it's a carp, we can see that much. I can hold it still on him. Sorry about this. There we go. That's Will and his nephew Dan. Dan's on the left as we're looking at it. It's the first time he's come with us on a trip, so hopefully he'll get a few fish this week as well. What I'll do is I'm just going to stick breakfast on to cook, and then I shall walk round and I'll go around and take some pictures and do a bit of filming of the fish. So I'll see you when I get round there. Cheers. Okay, so here we go. So this is fish number 2 for our group, and Will's got it this morning. Just rattled off as he was getting ready to come and get his breakfast, so perfect timing. How big was that one, mate?
34.2, I believe.
34.2, happy days, nice common there. Happy days. What did you get it on, mate? What bait was it?
On the V&F.
All right, excellent.
Pop up on a little rig.
Yeah, there's been fish all over you all night, hasn't it? So it was welcome getting that this morning. Mate. Perfect. All right, stick it down, mate, and then I'll do some stills. Okay, so I thought I'd just do a quick 2 minute catch up before I go and make tea for everyone. So it's what is it, Sunday evening now, just coming up to 4:45. I've got my rods out behind me there. It's unusual really, because I don't normally fish in the day when I come to France. I'll fish from sort of evening overnight till breakfast time and then reel in and then leave the rods out for the rest of the day. Rest of swims, but it was really overcast, a bit brighter now, but it was overcast earlier and it did look good for a bite, but it's not materialised for anyone during the day. So I've just been round, I've baited up my 3 spots again, probably another 7.5 kilo between the 3 spots, so that's probably just 15 to 17.5 kilo of bait I've done in the first 2 days. But again, the lake's got, you know, it's got countless 20s, countless 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s. So, you know, you put the bait in and they're hungry, they'll eat it. So, mixture of boilie and particle have gone out, so, on each of the spots. So, yeah, just where we're up to now. Fish, so I had the one last night, this morning, should I say. And then Will had one, which I did get on video, which was 34 common. That was at breakfast time this morning, so I've had 2 fish between the group up to now, so it's, you know, it's a bit slow really, but the fish are feeding, they're boshing and they're bubbling up and what have you, so I think we will work our way into it, and I've got a feeling that everyone certainly will catch, it's just about how many really, and whether we can get into any of the real big ones in here, but you know, it doesn't, we just want to catch a few fish really, so so I'm going to go and make tea for everybody now, and then I'll get my rods back out on the spots I've just baited up, and hopefully we'll have more than one fish during the night to show you, or well, in the morning, whenever, I don't really mind as long as I get them. So yeah, and with any luck a couple of the other lads will get something and I can get them on film as well. Okay, I'll catch up with you later on. Cheers. So here we go, this is Monday morning now, and this is Will, second fish of the session there. Beautiful mirror. I'm sorry about the lights, a bit dull, but you can see that's a stunning carp, that actually. Look at an old mirror, lovely scale pattern on it there, dark one. So yeah, you had this one this morning, didn't you, mate?
Yeah, 5:30. Yeah, what, the island.
You weighed it, yeah?
Yeah, 34 pound.
Yeah, what's it, and what did you get this one on this time?
That was on the old pop-up, the old V&F.
All right, so another one on V&F, yeah. Pop-up, yeah.
Just
happy
did
days
the for me now, that one.
Good. Right, okay, mate, just drop it down and then I'll get some stills of it. Excellent. Okay, so here we are. This is what day are we on now? Monday, lunchtime, I'd say, 12 o'clock. Been back to the cabin and made breakfast for everybody this morning and just come back. Just got all three rods back out. So, again, I'm going to have a go at fishing over during the day, should I say, again today. It's not really picked up or started as yet, but we're not doing too bad now. It's only Monday, lunchtime, and obviously I had the first one, then Will had one, and then Eamon had two last night, and Will had another one. So we're up to five carps now, and Pete also had a 46 cat during the night as well. So we've had six fish in total, but one of them was a catfish. The weather, now I don't know if you can see there, but it's just, there's a little bleep on me rod there. It's just perfect, this. It's about, probably about 17, 18 degrees. Wind's absolutely tatering down towards me. Really overcast. I mean, if you were to look for carp fishing conditions, it's been a prolonged spell of really warm weather in this area of France. I know they've had a few thunderstorms. I'm sure you've all seen the Gone Caught videos where it's been hit pretty hard in recent months, but on the whole, it's been really, really warm. And this weather is just like, you know, you couldn't ask for anything better really coming carp fishing. So I'm hoping that today's going to pick on a little bit. And so that's what tends to happen on this lake. You'll see them and they'll be boshing and they'll be rolling and they'll be bubbling and everything you'll be looking for to see where the fish are. And then quite often the fish activity will go dead on here, and then the next thing you'll all start picking up the fish. So, but yeah, I've seen them today while I was having breakfast. I was sort of, the kitchen is right down the bottom at the end of the channel there that I'm pointing into now, and I was watching back down the channel and the fish were lumping out while I was cooking breakfast. So they're here, they're just not really getting onto the bait as yet. So I've tried a slightly different tactic on my middle rod, slightly different baiting approach on that one. I'll see how that goes before I say too much. but yeah, so that's where we're up to. So five fish, well, we've had two 20s, two 30s and a 40 so far. Two of the lads still to catch yet, get off the mark, which is Andy, first time he's been here, and Dan, first time he's been here. But they're both in swims that do fish and do big fish as well, so I'm confident that they'll catch. The one thing, just depending on when people are coming out to France this year, I don't know how quickly I'll get the video done and on there, but I'm prone to mozzie bites anyway, but this year's been particularly bad, and it's only Monday, and I reckon I've probably got somewhere between 100 and 150 bites on my legs and my arms, and I've tried all the stuff, all the different products, different body lotions and bloody God knows what, and nothing seems to stop them for me. So I've just took some antihistamines, but just to make sure that everybody brings out plenty of protection. The one thing that is working at night is putting my mozzie panels down on the bivvy and then just lighting one of the mozzie coils. Obviously just make sure that it's safe where you put it, you don't want to burn your bivvy down. I haven't got a ground sheet in and it's just stones anyway, so it's fine. But and then putting that on at night seems to be doing the trick. I'm not having any problems with getting mozzie bites. So yeah, so hopefully either me or one of the other lads will catch something this afternoon. It'd be nice to get one in the day really. It's always good to get some pictures and some footage in the day. Yeah, and then I shall speak to you later on. Sorted. Okay, so here we go. This is a Tuesday morning, Lake Beauregard. This is the first of two fish that I've had this morning. A bit lively, been sat in the sling for a minute. This is a 31 pound mirror that I caught. Which one did I get this one on? I caught this on 12mm pineapple NM Butric on top of a 14mm VNF in the margin. Let's see if we can get her up, she's a bit lively. Come on. There we go, look at that beautiful fish again, stunners in here. 31 pound on the nose, BNF, pineapple and butric topper, over 3 kilos of Cheshire particle, and another kilo and a half of the Saab pellet that Roger sells at the lake. So Combination's still working well. Cheers. Okay, so this is Tuesday morning still. This is the second of the fish that I've had this morning. This is a mirror, 24-10. This one came off of the Impulse Apex, 15mm, pineapple and Butric pop-up again, Nutra baits, always use them. And yeah, got this one this morning, so 24-10. I'll show you both sides of this one, which I wouldn't normally do, because it's quite interesting. Stunning fish, but it has actually only got one eye. So for anyone else that's coming out here, I'll show both sides and then you can keep an eye out for it. Pardon the pun. Once again, absolutely beautiful fish. 24-10, stunning mirror this one. Same combination, a couple of kilos of the Cheshire Particle, kilo of pellet, kilo of boilies, Impulse Apex, and job's a good one. So I'll just drop her down, turn around, show you the other side, and then slip her back. Just had a bit of indication on the other rod, so I may have to zip off quickly. There we go. Just quickly there. You can see there, only one eye on this one. Right, I'm just going to go and put it back because I think I may have a take on the other rod.
Can't wait to roll it out of the way.
Okay, so here we are. This is Tuesday morning, Lake Beauregard, and Andy's just had a run while we were sat at the breakfast table, putting the world to rights. So first bit of action I think I've got out of any of the trips of someone playing a fish on camera. It was just Andy that I took my camera down to breakfast to show the lads some of the videos. So rather than filming the full fight, I'll let him get it sorted out and then I'll do some on the fish once he's got it in. Okay. Okay, so here we go. This is Tuesday morning again. I've just filmed Andy playing the fish for a little minute. It was the first time we've got one on camera. Sat down having breakfast and his rod's rattled off. And what have you got for us, Andy?
44-4.
44-4, common. And what was your PB before this?
42-14.
There we go. Beauregard has done another PB. Happy days. Let's have a look at it, mate. There we go, beautiful. Look at that. What'd you get him on, mate?
That's a special snail boilie, which isn't really sellable. Cheshire Particle test bait, but it's never going to come to the public at this stage.
Oh well, as long as we keep Team North in the mix here, mate, with these big ones, that'll be good for us. Look at that distinctive, a little bit of a split on his tail there, so you recognise him again. Beautiful, mate, well done. We'll get some stills of him and then put him back. Happy days.
Deep I'm going.
Is that your phone in your pocket, Andy?
No, it's my receiver.
Here we go then. This is Andy. His new PB, 44-4. Was it Monday morning?
Tuesday.
Tuesday morning. As the time flies when you're having fun. Long awaited. Well done, mate.
Bring its tail up a bit, mate. Just get it out of it.
Let me just come a little bit out. Hold on a second.
Okay, so here we go. This is Tuesday afternoon now, 1:30 in the afternoon. Fourth day at Beauregard. And the fishing sort of picked up a little bit last night, I guess. I had two fish during the night that you've seen, the 30 and a 20. Andy had a PB at breakfast time, 44-4 common, so that was great. I was chatting to Andy shortly after he caught it, and asked him when he caught his previous PB to that, which was 42, and it was actually 20 years ago on his first ever trip to France that he did, so
that was awesome really, that he's come here and he's been rewarded with a fish like that. And it was spawned out, that fish. I'm sure that would have been pushing 50 pound a couple of months ago, but 44.4 is still an awesome fish, and again it's a PB for him, so he's over the moon really with that. Yeah, I've kept the bait going in down this end of the lake. I bet I've probably done nearly 35 kilo of bait now since I've been here, between particle, boilers and pellet. Heavily, 20 kilo of particle at least gone in, 8 kilo of pellet and 7 kilo of boilers, I'd say that's what it's divided up by. Last night really was active in my swim. I had fish boshing on my margin spot, I had fish boshing on me open water spot, on fish boshing down the channel that's behind me there. Caught my first fish off my margin spot, then I lost one in a snag that I just couldn't do anything about, unfortunately, in the open water spot. And then I picked one up this morning from that channel. So I've had fish off all three of my spots, which I always think when you come to a venue like this, if you can get them feeding on all three spots, it's ideal really, rather than relying on one spot fishing well. So what I'm going to do after, I'm going to show you the rig that I use in the UK or France. It's a very simple to tie rig, I think. Some people might find it a bit more complicated, but I certainly think anybody with a bit of practice could get it. I use it whether or not I'm fishing pop-ups, bottom baits, snowman, whatever. Sorry, it's a wasp. That fishing bait presentation I'm using, I'll use the same thing. Solid bags I'll even use it in. So. Yeah, not that I particularly use solid bags, not something I ever really do in my fishing. Obviously, zig rigs I'll tie differently because you have to, but I'll just show you the rig and then I'll talk you through how I tie it. I won't go through the process of tying it because I'm sure everyone will be bored to death with that, but I'll just show you the rig on top of a bait tub and then talk about how I tie it up and the versatility of it and what's good about it as far as understanding whether you're getting you've been picked up or not. So I'll do that shortly, and then hopefully before that I'll have another fish to show you. Thank you. So here we are. This is Wednesday evening, Wednesday night on Lake Beauregard. I've not really done any filming or footage today because it's been a bit of a tricky day, really. What can I say? Well, yesterday evening, it just went completely flat calm. The temperature was quite warm, maybe sort of 17, 18 degrees, and it stayed that way all night. And it was bizarre, considering I'd given an update saying that the night before they were showing over all three of the spots. Last night was just absolutely silent, nothing on any spot. So same for all the lads around the lake. And then basically one of the lads from the other end, Eamon, who's fishing peg one, said, I think they're pairing up in my swim. I've heard them freshing about during the night. So we all had a bit of a look round this morning and he was right. Yeah, they started to spawn again during the night last night. So, I don't know. Roger had mentioned earlier in the week that it's been a bit of a weird year on here. Spawning wise, they've spawned about four or five times. So probably now five or six times, which most lakes, I guess, is unheard of, really. Get once or twice, sometimes three times, but five or six is a lot, really. We've caught fish that have been spawned out, so they obviously have been spawning successfully, but I don't know. So there's nothing you can do. So I went to the supermarket earlier on today, got the barbecue food for tomorrow instead of waiting till tomorrow. We've had a game of dominoes and just a bit of a social today, really. So, I'm on a Aldi's finest lemon and lime pop tonight rather than any beer, because I've had a few of them during the day, so I thought I'd give it a miss while I've got my rods back out. So we've all done the same. It's tough really when it comes to, especially coming to France and the spawning. I know some people's opinions are lakes should be shut down and let them get on with it, and then I guess for like Roger, who's got his business here, they've spawned five or six times, so he couldn't really shut down 5 or 6 weeks, because otherwise he wouldn't have had any customers this year. So, I mean, what we've done is we've just reeled in all day, let them get on with it. And to be fair, come, I'd say probably 1 o'clock this afternoon, very little signs of spawning. There was the odd one every half an hour, but really there was next to nothing. So, you know, it did get up to 32 degrees, I think, was the warmest it got to today. So it's been pretty hot. I don't really know whether or not the, if it gets too warm, they stop spawning, but I'm guessing that the energy that they have to use to spawn, if it gets to 30 odd degrees, it's too hot. I don't think there's any risk to the eggs. I think there's probably risk to the fish if they put too much effort into doing it. So, so we've just thought, we've left it, we've had tea, and we've all got back on the rods about half eight, half nine now, so about an hour ago. And basically just moved our rods off the spots that we were, if we were anywhere near where they were spawning, like I had my left-hand rod was down in the margin. I've just pulled it off, fishing in open water. Funny enough, I've just had a fish come up there over my open water spot. I have stuck on that one. There's been no signs of spawning over that all day. So that's, I don't know, 40 yards away from the closest margin where they've been spawning. So, and my one down the channel behind me here, I was fishing to the edge of the channel, and now I've just moved it into the middle. Again, where there's been no signs of spawning. So it's all you can do, really. You know, we don't want to catch fish while they're spawning. But likewise, we're pretty sure that there is fish in here that have spawned and finished spawning, and there's been the odd one boshing out and lumping out in open water, so they are still knocking about. So yeah, I don't know, it's tough. No one had a bite during the evening, no one had a bite overnight. I think Dan had a 4-pound catfish, that was it, today on a zig, bizarrely, and that's it. So yeah, you know, we didn't really expect to get any fish today. It's the spawning, what can you do? We have probably plenty of people watching this out there that have experienced it, and it's pointless getting too worked up about it. There's absolutely nothing you can do apart from accept it's happening and just let them get on with it. So yeah, I don't know, we're expecting colder temperatures tomorrow, and especially tomorrow night, saying it's going to go down to about 8-9 degrees tomorrow night, so that may help us out and knock them off it a little bit. But again, normally if they spawn, it takes a few days for them to sort themselves out. So it is what it is. We'll just crack on and see whether or not we pick up the odd fish. But certainly now it's not going to be prolific. There's not going to be too many fish caught between the group, I wouldn't have thought. And again, it is what it is. What can you do? So yeah, the light's fading now. It's probably 9:30. And I've put my three rods out and just see how it goes. So you never know. I may have a fish for you during the night. If not, I'll see you again in the morning. Okay, so here we are. This is Friday morning, Lake Beauregard. I'm not actually in my peg at the moment. I've come down to see Eamon because he's had a fish this morning. Again, like I said last night, they stopped spawning yesterday, but it has been tough going. I had one during the night, 34. Eamon's had one this morning. So basically, we're not going to tell you the weight of this fish, because the competition that I mentioned that we were going to be running when I went over to see Mark, this is going to be the first fish of the competition prize. So basically, Eamon's going to show you the fish and tell you what he caught it on, but he's not going to tell you the weight. So we'll have this fish, and then I'll introduce the next one, and the two fish together, whoever can guess the combined weight of the two fish together and post their answer on the Facebook page, I'll run the competition for 2 weeks, and whoever gets the answer either completely correct or the closest to the ounce, the first person closest to the ounce is going to win the prize, which is 20 kilo of multi-mix supplied by Mark at Cheshire Particle. A Cheshire Particle t-shirt and a Carp Bible t-shirt, so it's a decent prize to win. Like I said, I'll post the competition on Facebook, and this will be the first fish of the competition, and it'll be guess the weight of this one, plus hopefully we'll catch another one, and it'll be guess the weight of that one, the two combined. We shall see. OK,
Okay, so here we go. This is Eamon's just going to show us the fish. Like I said before, this is the first fish of the competition, so it's guess the weight of this one plus the weight of the next one, providing that we catch one between the six of us, and the two together will be the competition total, and then the prize will come on the back of that. There we go, look at that. So you had that one this morning, did you, mate?
I did, yes. That was on a V&F wafter over a bed of V&F and Cheshire particle.
Happy days.
On IQ D-rig.
Excellent, good stuff. Well done, mate. Okay, so I thought I would just quickly show you the new 5-litre buckets from Cheshire Particle that you can order with whichever of their particle mixes that you desire. It could be just hemp on its own, it could be maize on its own, it could be hemp and maize. As usual, I've got the multi-mix, Super 6 multi-mix in this one. On the right-hand side of the shot is the 2.5 kilo bags. That's what, if you order it, a bulk order off the internet, they'll be delivered in them, unless you obviously order the 5-litre buckets. You can roughly get 5 kilo a particle, any mixes in the buckets, but the Tiger's weighing at about 4.5 kilo just because of the space that they take up in the bucket. Ready prepared, delivered to your door, so that's great if you want to take it straight out on a session. Likewise, if you get 10 kilo, 20 kilo of any of the other mixes and you want to just take 2.5 kilo on a session, just take one of them small bags with you, and they're resealable as well, so that's good. That's just my bait scoop on the left hand side that I've been using all week to put the stuff out with. And then once again, yeah, it's produced well for me. We have had a tough week this week, but I've had a 40, two 30s and a 20 in really tough conditions when the fish were spawning halfway through the week. So, and they've all come over a bed of this mix, Cheshire Particle mix. I've put out, I think, 25 to 30 kilo of that this week. I'm pretty sure if the fish were on it, I'd have ran out by now and I'd have been struggling a little bit. I bought 35 kilo with me, I'd have easily gone through that, and I probably could have gone through another 15 kilo, I'd have thought, if the fish were having it this week. Yeah, they really do seem to respond well to this stuff. So, and again, the previous clip was Eamon with his mirror, didn't give the weight away, and that's because there's a prize being given away by Mark from Cheshire Particle, very kindly of him, and he's going to run it through this video, and the prize is 10 kilo of the multi-mix that you can see in front of you, delivered free of charge, and then we're going to incentivize it by offering some additional prizes if we can get a set amount of likes and shares on the video. So there'll be a Cheshire Particle t-shirt if we reach so many likes, and a Carp Bible t-shirt if we reach so many shares thrown in, and they'll be delivered all at the same time. So the total prize that you could win is 10 kilo of bait delivered and two t-shirts free of charge. So again, if you want anything at all, any custom mixes, just give Mark an email, contact him through Facebook, or give him a ring, and he's more than willing to entertain your ideas and try and put something together for you and get it out, delivered out to you. Okay, so here we are. It's Friday night now, our last night on the lake. I'm not sure what's going on there. I don't know if that's a fault with Delcam, that every 2 minutes it's bleeping singly. I don't have to read the instructions to see if there's something wrong with it. My alarm clock's beeping. Last night, and basically it's been a tough week, really. Started off slowish, but you know, okay, you expect it. Saturday night, changeover, finding spots, bait going in, usual stuff about a French venue like this. Had a few fish. Sunday, same. Monday, sort of felt like it was building then towards being, the fish were coming on and starting to feed well. A few came out Monday night, Tuesday morning, I think five between the group and 44 for Andy. And then they started spawning on, they started pairing up on Tuesday afternoon, I would say, because that's when the lake shut down. Tuesday night they started spawning, Wednesday had it all day, Thursday night had it. So really it's only been yesterday mid-morning and then today they've stopped. Well, no, they stopped yesterday morning, but they've started to look like they want to feed and they've sort of got it out of the system. So yeah, so we've not fished particularly hard, you know, just point when they're spawning, there's not a lot you can do. You don't want to fish them while they're doing it.
there's obviously fish that aren't spawning that you can fish for, but I don't know, it does affect the whole lake. So I don't know, the wind's been up, it's cooled down a bit. I think I'm feeling good about tonight. I had another one last night, 34. I think I'll probably get one tonight, hopefully more than one. It's the rest of the group, really. I'm desperate for Dan to catch one. He's first time with us. He's a good fisherman, good angler, knows what he's doing. He's just, it's just not gone for him, really. But I hope he gets one tonight. I'm desperate for him to catch one, really. And it'd be nice for Pete to get, I don't even know what his biggest carp is so far, but it's not particularly big anyway. So we had a 46 cat earlier on in the week, but I think his biggest carp was 19 or something. So yeah, it'd be nice for him to get a bigger one. But, I don't know what else to say. Baiting approach has had to change throughout the week as the fish have dictated. I've kept it going in. Sort of tried to keep them feeding even when it's been slow. I don't know. I'm hoping that I'll start seeing a few now and then just pick one up during the night. So I could do with getting another one between the group, because this competition that I've mentioned that we're doing with Mark at Cheshire Particle, to complete the competition, I need another fish from somebody. So so hopefully someone will get one in the morning or tonight, and we can get some footage of it, and then that'll be the second one for the prize. So yep, I'll have to see, but I don't know. Not much else to say other than great week, great group, lovely lake, some amazing fish in here. Just one of them. We never anticipated middle of June we'd get caught out with spawning. We thought they'd be done by then, and it's not happened like that. So you know, we've all been plenty of holidays. We've all been caught out with fish spawning before, and there's nothing you can do. You can't beat yourself up. You can't get too disheartened. We've eaten well. We've had a few beers. We've got on well. Plenty of laughs and plenty of memories, and just another great trip. Roger's been great, Sarah. The lake's been stunning as usual. And tonight, I'm hoping that somebody gets rewarded with one of the big ones in here. One of the 60s would be excellent. A 50 would be great. Just a fish for somebody would be nice, really. Okay.
Okay, so here we go. I gave that update before. Friday night, and Eamon's got the first one of the evening. He's absolutely leading the way at the minute with regards to the fishing. He's hammering them. Right, don't tell us the weight of this one, mate, because this is the second one of the competition for the Cheshire Particle and Carp Bible T-shirt prize. Another absolutely stunning fish there. What did you get that one on, mate?
That was on the VNF Wafter again on the IQD rig over the Cheshire Particle.
Right, happy days. Is that your biggest one of the week, mate?
Biggest one of the week. Big fish Friday.
Oh, you saved it for Friday. Right, well, I need to get back to me rods because I'm going to have a bigger one. So, okay, just a side note, that actually puts Team South in the lead on the match, doesn't it, mate? So, pressure on Team North now for the rest of the night. Okay, well done. Happy days. Okay, so here we go. I'm back in my shed at the end of yet another week's trip in France. And just do a quick summary, I guess. So, where do we start? Yeah, it's like I said at the start of the video, slightly different trip this time in the fact that we went on Friday morning instead of Saturday, travelling through the night and getting there on Saturday. So we stayed at a campsite, had the north-south match, Silver's match that was supposed to be with a carp rod out. Unfortunately, as you'll probably have seen from earlier in the video, it wasn't as successful as we thought it might be. And Team South managed to take the scalp with that one. I think had 520 grams or something, and we had 260 or something. So, you know, I'm not sure the lake had as many fish as it suggested in there, but hey ho, it was a bit of fun anyway, and we enjoyed camping overnight. So, yeah, so down to the lake on Saturday. And basically it started off quite well. Saturday was quiet, as you expect. Sunday started to fish okay. Monday picked up really well, and then they started spawning Tuesday, and basically that was us till Friday night, really. So yeah, is what it is. So I'll just go through some of the numbers quickly that we actually had. I've done a bit of a log here so that I can just summarize what we've had. So we had 17 carp in total,
five commons, 10 mirrors, two grass carp, and within that we had two high doubles, 420s, 730s and 440s, with the biggest fish being 45.2, which was the mirror that I had on the first night. Andy had the biggest common at 44, and Andy also had the biggest grassy at 30 pounds. So so again, tough week, but it's done 440s for the group. You know, it's fish that you just don't get, well, some people get to catch them in England, but being three northern anglers in the contingent, you just don't get to catch them sort of fish in England, really, in the north. So so that's a great trip. But we're booking back on to Beauregard again for 2020. We're looking for a venue because there's a couple more of us going in 2019. Two of the fellas, it's their 60th birthday. I won't mention names for which ones it is, but yeah, so we're looking for a slightly bigger venue because there's a couple more guests coming along to celebrate their birthday. So that'll be 2019. 2020 back on Beauregard. October we're looking at this time, so be interesting to see how the fishing goes. Then we've done early in the year, we've done middle of the year, so slightly later in the year, we'll just see how it goes and see. Hopefully we'll avoid spawning October, but the way this year's gone, you never know, we could get caught out, but I wouldn't have thought so. So yeah, so as I usually do at the end of the video, just a couple of thank yous really. Obviously a massive thank you to Roger and Sarah and their two sons for having the lake in absolute pristine condition. Fish were awesome again, the facilities were great, lovely. Roger was fantastic, as always. Sarah was lovely, so that's it's always a bonus about going to a lake in France when the owners are so accommodating and grateful for you coming out there, and the facilities are you know, as you would hope. And just a fantastic Lake Beauregard. I absolutely love the place, and I definitely will have many more trips out there. Big thanks to Mark at Cheshire Particle for doing the competition. Hopefully we'll get plenty of likes and shares on the video. I don't want to flog it to death, but again, you know, if you're looking for a particle bait of any description, whether it's hemp, tigers, maize, anything at all, just get on his stuff. It's absolutely fantastic stuff, great value, and he'll deliver it out to you. And again, as I said at the start of the video, custom mixes. If you want to tweak any recipes, add anything into them, just give him a shout, and I'm sure he'll be more than accommodating of doing that. He really does. All he wants is good customer service and a great product going out there, which is, I think, what most of us want out of our carp fishing, of any, whether it's tackle or bait or whatever it is, a lake that we go to. Big thanks to Paul Branwood Meats at Bury Market. Any northern anglers that live anywhere near Bury, if you're going out to France and you're looking to take some food out with you, give them a shout. I mean, they were just awesome. I ordered enough food to keep six lads going, full English every day. Proper cooked meal every evening. We had lamb, we had chicken, we had bloody steaks, we had barbecue food, we had everything. It was all vat packed, all ready for me. I went and picked it up, they had it all in boxes, ready to go, vat packed. And and all the lads all vouch for it, that the food that they do is absolutely cracking stuff. And obviously you get the perk, if you're a northerner, you'll get the perk of Bury black pudding, which, as much as the southerners won't want to admit it, they do love the stuff. So so there we go. I'm not too sure when the next video will be. Obviously we've got the France trip next year. Hopefully I'll get out and do some filming before then, but I probably said that at the end of the video last year and I've not managed to do it. It's just work commitments and family commitments just mean that I only really get to do my France trips. But I will desperately try and get out and do some in the UK, so I can get more filming done. I love doing these videos, and I love the fact that people get to watch it and share our experiences, and hopefully get some information about the lake that they're going to, and it can help them out when they go over there. Again, any questions about the lakes that we feature, or any questions? I know I did a bit about the rig this time. I'm sure it's not, you know, some people will be looking at it thinking, what the bleeding hell is that? Back to the 90s. Some people will be looking at it hopefully thinking, oh, it's quite a good rig and I'll incorporate that in my fishing. Either way, it's, I just did it in it just because maybe there may be people that are interested. If people have got their own preferences, then that's absolutely fine. It's each to their own, as I've always said. So yeah, so the last thing I also want to say is a massive thanks to Pete, Will, Eamon, Little Dan and Andy for making it a fantastic trip. We've sort of, the groups come together from all over the country, really, from different people putting us together and going on trips together. And again, we've had a pretty tough week this week. 17 fish isn't really what we were expecting, but the one thing that we did get was a fantastic week, great friends, loads of memories. The Southerners have spanked us in two matches. I will squeeze that in at the end of the video. I was trying to avoid it, but I will show you what the totals were behind me here. So this is the match board. I don't know if the camera will pick it up or not. It's a bit tough, but yeah. But anyway, the totals were... Oh, there we go. I've got it now. Team North, £210, 6 ounces. Team South, £321, 2 ounces. So not only have they beat us in the Silvers match, they've beat us in the Carp match as well, which unfortunately we're going to have to wait a year now to avenge that loss. But hopefully Team North will come good on the next trip. But again, like I said, the matches and that are just purely good humour. And personally, I just love getting away with a bunch of lads that we've got together. They're a fantastic group. They make it a great week. Tough week for, Dan didn't catch any carp, unfortunately, but his spirits aren't dented. He's ready to go for next year, and he knows that he'll get a few next year when we go. So, yep, hope you enjoy the video. Competition running, 20 kilo of particle delivered free, possibly 2 t-shirts if we get enough shares and enough likes. Get on Cheshire Particle Facebook page, like it, follow the stuff that they're doing. Get on the Carp Bible page. The more stuff I can get posted on there off members of the public, great. I'll share it and get it out to people, and I look forward to doing the next video. So thanks for watching, and enjoy the photographs. Cheers.
times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love.